Helen is receiving our award tonight because not only did she create a company, she created a community of academic and industry leaders, people who are creating a technology that is saving lives, as you've seen, and improving life experiences. She has taught us all that dreams can become a reality. R2-D2 is really your role model, huh? Please welcome Helen Greiner.
Well, thank you. Thank you very much. So I believe that technology enables people to make a positive impact on society by addressing the really big problems. You know, when you think about it, who's going to find a solution to the long-term energy issues we face? Who's going to invent technologies that give our aging population the freedom to remain living independently? Who's going to make potable water available to the millions of children who die each year of diarrheal diseases? And who's going to design vehicles and environments that let our species migrate to different planets? The answer, of course, is technologists, like many of the people in this room. And we, all of us here, I believe, have the obligation to future generations to ensure we have the best and brightest engineers and scientists. And I worry, there's a big concern, that half the population still gets subtly, and sometimes not so subtly, directed away from technology as a career path. And, of course, I worry about this because I'm a geek. I've always been a geek. And sure, you can call it a bookworm, or you can call it studious, or something else, but let's face it, I'm a geek, and I'm proud of it. And yet, when I was growing up, not one person told me that I should be an engineer. Even though I was on a computer since I was 11, I did math team, I did chess team, I was the computer lab maven like many of the people probably were in this room. And not one person actually suggested studying engineering. In fact, when I was in high school, I saw a PBS special that showed MIT students building robots, and by the end of it, I decided if I was going to build R2-D2, I was going to go to school there. But, you know, what a coincidence. And so I worry that if I wasn't encouraged, even with all the outward appearances of a geek, you know, what about the girls who haven't yet gravitated in this direction? And so you'll say, well, that was a long, long time ago in a galaxy far, far away. But, you know, it still happens today. And a friend's grade school girl was recently told, you won't need math. I still hear a lot more women than men say, I'm not good with tools, or I'm not good with computers, or maps, or numbers. And, you know, kids listen, and they pick up these cues on how we're supposed to act as an adult. And, you know, I know people in this room, and this organization does a great job of getting statistics out there, but if there's only 20% women studying engineering, that's over 100,000 girls who are not given the opportunity to impact the future through invention, discovery, and design. Or they're not taking advantage of this opportunity. And it doesn't have to be a zero-sum game. We don't need to kick the boys out, because we need more engineers and scientists. The whole world needs more. And why is it so important that women are included and minorities are included? It's because this diversity of perspectives that you can see at our company really yields a diversity of different types of designs. And in fact, even the problems that our future engineers and scientists decide to tackle are driven in part by their life experiences. And so we need more women's life experiences influencing our direction and designs. We need technologies that will make a difference for the entire planet, and we need technologies that will give us more work-life balance. I know I do. So, what are we going to do about it? Well, four things. First, getting together with women at events like this and talking about the issues collectively to come up with great new innovative solutions. I'm so inspired, and I've heard many women in this room come and say to me, I've got a great job, but I decided I wanted to give back to younger women more, so I'm dedicating more time to an organization like this, or going into teaching, or even getting out and speaking to the younger generation. Second, I think we have to implement technology as a subject in school curriculums. I sit on the board of the Boston Museum of Science, and it's part of our mission. The president there, Yanis Mayalis or something like that, points out, until now, school curriculum focuses on the natural world, but it's the technological or the human-made world that really facilitates 95% of our experience every day. And so we need to make math and science really come to life and be relevant to students, and engineering design challenges do this. It allows students to apply their knowledge of these math and science subjects. And third, hundreds of thousands of kids across the country each year are building robots. That's pretty cool. We'll hopefully employ them. In one program called BotBall, they're building and programming on the iRobot Create, which I'm personally very proud of. And also FIRST, which many folks in this room participate and mentor in and volunteer in. They're making robotic challenges have as much appeal to kids as sporting events. And these programs really work, because when kids build a robot, they get really, really excited about engineering as a career. And fourthly, and lastly, I believe we need to plant the golden seeds by expressing our belief in the abilities and potential of children. And this was a concept that's been popularized by Charles Handy, a British management guru. But I think we need the engineering and technology equivalent. Maybe we'll call it the innovation spark. And it's really amazing what a movie or an encouraging remark make at the right time in a person's life can have this huge, immense, positive impact. So along these lines, I just want to encourage everyone here to give kids, regardless of their gender, the following types of encouragement. You are really good at building things. That's a great idea you came up with. Have you thought about engineering as a career? I think you would be good at it. You can start as young as 4 on this. And especially, you want to help people, because I know a lot of little girls want to help people. Well, engineering is the most effective way to fulfill your goal to make a difference. So let's all spread the word to kids. You know, this award's for innovation, and they will come up with things that I would never dream of if we tell them very early on that they can. And, you know, I'm honored to be selected for this award because, you know, connecting more women to technology, I think, is truly going to make the world a better place. So thank you.